Diplomatic relations between the Philippines and the Islamic Republic of Iran was established in 1964. As we celebrate 50 years of friendship, Iran is looking forward to a more expanded bilateral relations focused on economic cooperation, trade, cultural, and communication exchanges. And tonight we are privileged to have with us on News Live the head of the public diplomacy of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the Islamic Republic of Iran, the Honorable Ramin Mehman Parast, and His Excellency Ambassador Ali Ashghar Mohammadi. Good evening, sirs, and welcome to News Live.
Thank you very much. I would like at first convey my regards to very kind people of Philippines, and it's my pleasure to visit this beautiful country after 18 years.
Thank you very much also. Good evening to you.
Let's start with His Excellency Ambassador Mohammadi. How important is this visit in forging closer ties between ours?
I think we are not this very new, the beginning of the relationship, and I believe there are the basic grounds for developing our relationship and expand in different areas, economically, politically, and culturally. So this is a very auspicious occasion to see Excellency Ramin Mehman Parast here in the Philippines, and we would enjoy tomorrow with topics and discussion in the DFA.
Mm-hmm. Honorable Mehman Parast, as a major oil-producing country, are there plans from your government and Iranian companies to invest in petrochemical plants here?
Surely, we believe that the capacity between two countries, it's huge, and we should use this opportunity to have more joint venture and more common project. We think that the petrochemical is one of the best item to cooperation, mm-hmm. and we will be active in the petrochemical investment in Philippines, and in the future we will have some other programs to be more shared in this activity in Philippines.
Just to add to this, what other industries are you looking at investments here in the Philippines?
I think that the situation of economy in the world, especially after the big economic crisis in the West, guide us to cooperate more than before, and we should use this capacity between the Asian countries. The situation of the Philippines is very important for us because it's one of the important countries in the Southeast of Asia, mm-hmm. and the Iran is very important situation in the West of Asia and near the Central Asia countries. We can join these two regions, and we should encourage all of the Iranian people and investors to come to Philippines. And we think that we can find so many important projects to be more active bilateral cooperation and trilateral with the other countries.
Ambassador Mohammadi, given the economic growth in the Philippines, will you convince Iranian investors to come in the Philippines, invest, especially in Mindanao?
Of course, with the good news we are hearing from the economic growth of Philippines, I think the investors already has been alarmed. Is a good destination for investment and trade, so we are going to see more exchanges of the delegation between private sectors and Chamber of Commerce, and also, of course, because of the very unique situation of the agro-industries in Mindanao, I think Mindanao would be a very good center for the trade and investment.
Mm-hmm. Now, the Philippines has more than 7,100 islands, many beautiful destinations. Will more Iranians visit the Philippines in the future and look at it as a tourist destination?
Of course, I think Philippines deserves to see more Iranian tourists, and basically we have signed MOU with the Philippine government about the expansion of tourism. So I believe the travel agency should be more active in this part, and we are going to start a new beginning about the tourism, which is very encouraging in the future.
Mm-hmm. Ambassador, here in the Philippines, there are a lot of Filipinos who go abroad to find work. We call OFWs, Overseas Filipino Workers. There in Iran, are there a lot of OFWs coming from the Philippines?
I think if you go back to the past, I think the OFW stories has started from Iran in the 1970s. But recently, we see less, the OFWs in Iran. In fact, we are thinking that based on the project-based, there will be a possibility to to hire these OFWs in Iran, but still we do have some, I mean, hundreds of OFWs working in Iran, especially in the south of Iran.
Now that we're trying to forge a more strategic and more a stronger relationship between the Philippines and Iran, do you see more Filipinos trying to get work in Iran and vice versa, foreign investment from Iran coming here?
We think that the ground is ready, but we should study the main project and we should have some common joint venture and common project. We should define some different project as the base of the situation in Iran and Philippines and other countries that we can have multilateral cooperation with them. I hope that in the future we can use more Philippinian human power in different projects in Iran and other countries.
Sir, so you met with our general manager, Mr. Cleo Dongaas. Are you looking forward to more cultural and communication exchanges to promote the friendship of our two countries?
Surely, we have some MOU with the governmental television of Philippines, and we are following this agreement. In the future, we can exchange some production from two sides, and we think that because of common culture between two countries and the quality of the production in Iran, we can use these experiences to exchange of the news, analyses, reports, and some films and serials that I think that the people of Philippines and people of Iran like to see these products.
Ambassador Mohammadi, what are your expectations in the discussions with the network and also with the Philippine government in terms of forging stronger ties?
I think this is a time that we should think that we should have a direct link between the news agencies of the two countries, because it is overwhelmingly from the Western media, so I think we should bring a new picture to our relationship based on the mutual cooperation, which is very straight, and we can see firsthand the information through this cooperation.
Mm-hmm. And a final word, let's start with Honorable Mema.
I should say that the role of public diplomacy is very important. And if we want to have the better cooperation and strengthen the relationship between two countries, we should introduce the capacity in Iran and Philippines to the people. And we think that the role of media is very important. We should encourage them to have direct connection and direct cooperation together. They can inform the people about some different interesting items and subjects to the people. They can encourage the people to be more active, to invest, and increase the trade and business between two countries as like as cultural activity. Mm-hmm. And the role of tourism agencies is very important too. We are following cooperation between the media and tourism activities. We hope that in the future we can use this capacity to have more cooperation and expansion of very good relationship between Iran and Philippines.
Mm-hmm. Ambassador Mohammadi, final words?
Thank you very much for this opportunity given to us. I think this is a time developments, new developments in the Middle East after the election in Iran, and the interest of the Iran to show the different face of Iran through democratic situation. So I believe that we should start a new beginning in our relationship between Iran and Philippines. I see many, many opportunities that hopefully would be utilized by both sides. Thank you very much.
Okay, on that note, thank you very much, sirs, for joining us here tonight at News Live. The Honorable Ramin Memanparas and Ambassador Ali Asghar Mohammadi. Thank you, sirs. Good evening.